scientists discovered that individuals with more brain activity learn slower than those with less brain activity. So stop thinking and learn. Wait, what? Hi everyone, Crystal here for DNews, exploring the idea that overthinkers like me may learn new tasks more slowly and be less successful at those tasks than those who don't analyze and evaluate their every move. Scientists have known for a while that cognitive control from the frontal cortex can have a depressing effect on our ability to learn new tasks. This is probably because that brain region is responsible for problem solving, planning, and execution, and its top-down regulation of our behavior can lead us to make things more complicated for ourselves than they really are. Children learn way faster than adults because they're not subject to this cortical control. They can't overthink because their judgy frontal cortex hasn't even been developed yet. This is one reason why kids are more creative and frequently take risks than an adult probably wouldn't. When humans are exposed to a new task, almost our entire brain is active and desperately trying to make sense and associations from the new input. As we get better at that task and figure it out, this global network activity gets pruned to only what we need specifically for task performance. How quickly the specification happens corresponds to how quickly we learn the task. Researchers at several universities looked at this process across the whole brain and recorded which regions maintained their connections and activity and which ones didn't. These data were recorded as fMRI scans of whole brain as subjects learned a simple musical computer game. The scientists were hoping to visualize the changes that happened as people learned, but what they didn't expect is that subject data would organize itself into two categories, fast learners and slow learners. Those who learned the musical video game very quickly showed a rapid drop-off of global brain activation. The slow learners maintained more global brain activity over the 6-week trial and showed prolonged involvement of associative regions of the cortex. This led researchers to conclude that overthinking, by maintaining vigilance, monitoring errors, and frequently making associative judgments, makes it more difficult for individuals to transform a task from slow and challenging to fast and automatic. Now, more studies are needed to truly understand this process, but it very well could be that analyzing your thinking about what you are trying to learn isn't really doing you any favors, and it's making it harder for you to be successful. So get out of your own way, stop second guessing and re-optimizing everything, and just let it happen. I should take my own advice. What do you think? What tasks are you making more difficult for yourself? Let us know in the comments down below and subscribe to DNews. And follow me on Twitter, @PollyCrystalHD.